And the crowd is in mid-season form at Legion Field.
Don't you love college football, Jim? They get here 3 hours ahead of time. They fill up the stands.
Here's Scott Slater's kickoff. And this is the freshman, Bobby Humphreys, at the three-yard line. 15, 20, got speed. Knocked out of bounds across the 35-yard line by Scott Slater, the kicker. From the 41, second down, 5. And here comes Turner, the fullback out of Gaithersburg, Maryland, very near a first down. And the bullet got him, Steve Bullet. Great speed at outside linebacker. 3rd and inches, they give it to Braggs, and Braggs has got the first down out near the 48-yard line. And first man through is Turner. Turner's got the first down to the 40-yard line of Texas A&M. Richardson and Bell, the wide receivers. Split backs. Shula hands to Braggs. Big open hole. Braggs makes a good cut inside the 30-yard line. First down, Alabama. Cut down by Lamar Kelm, the linebacker. Now they have second down, and let's call it 6. And here's Turner, the fullback. And Turner turns the corner and may have the first down. They'll mark it at the 20. That'll be shy of the first down by a yard. 2 tight ends for Alabama. 4 down linemen for Texas A&M. They've taken out a defensive back. They give it to Braggs, and Braggs has the first down, I believe, near the 18-yard line. Alabama with the ball, a little mix-up in the backfield. That's Braggs, big hold off the football, but it is picked up by Shula alertly at the 20-yard line. And for the first down, the Tide has lost ground on the play. Bell in motion, Shula back to throw, has the time, delivers the ball to Bell, first down inside the 5-yard line, first and goal to go at the 2. That was the winning combination against Georgia. There goes Braggs, and that's a touchdown, Alabama. Nelson prodding in motion. Ball straight ahead. That's Anthony Toney, the fullback. And he gets the ball out to about the 39-yard line. A good pickup of 5-6 yards, let's call it. Stump back for his first throw. If he can get it away, puts the ball up. Diving catch. Is it good? If it is, it's a first down. That is Anthony Toney out of the backfield, and it is labeled good. The ball is at the 44, at its first down, Texas A&M. And Stump gets the ball away, has the man there. First down, Texas A&M. Shea Walker, the split on number 85. And on him is Roy Turner, the free safety. Walker left and Jeff Nelson to the right. And Toney, the fullback, with the football, and he lost the football. They're chasing it. And it looks as though Roy Turner got it for Alabama. 3rd and 15, Alabama. And Braggs is going to carry the ball for a couple of yards. And that is Johnny Harland, again, leading the way, number 11. Short kick, short kick. May get the good bounce, but short kick. Nope, it's not going to get the good bounce for Alabama. Gets the good bounce for Texas A&M. Very short kick. The ball only carries to the 47, third down and short. And Valentine is in there with Toney, 2 fullbacks. They give the ball to Toney, who follows Valentine, and he is written down by Larry Roberts, the senior defensive end out of Dothan, Alabama.
Jim, I still think he got the first down if it were they marked the ball.
1st and 10 from the Alabama 41, and here's Stump on first down. The throw across the middle, he has Rich Seiler, the tight end, and picks up 8 yards down to the 32-yard line. Stump to his regular, Toney, and Toney slips out of a tackle of Larry Roberts and goes ahead, and Bennett comes up to help out. And I think he's got the first down just shy of the 30-yard line. And Toney is back. There's the lone running back. And Tony's got the football. And Toney does not have the first down. Now Randy Rockwell led the tacklers along with Ricky Thomas, the strong safety. And when he came on in his first game, he kicked a 50-yard and a 45-yarder. He's going to be called on here to kick a 40-yarder, barefooted kicker, out of Fort Worth, Texas. Hasn't missed as a collegiate. from 40 yards out with a flag up. The kick is no good, but let's see what the flag is.
Well, if it's delay of game, Jim, it's an automatic penalty. They've got to take the penalty, don't they?
There you are. Franklin could hit this from 45 out. From 45 out, he's got the leg, and this one is no good either. So he missed from 40 and then 45. Bell to the right, Richardson to the left. Humphrey and Turner in the backfield. And Shula back to throw. Has the time, drilled it. See, he dropped the ball, that's Richardson. They're going to call it an incomplete pass, not a fumble, and a recovery by A&M. 7-0 Alabama. Second quarter, first down, Texas A&M at their own 30. Nelson, the man in motion, and here's Murray back to throw on first down. And he gets the ball out to Nelson, and that's 6 or 7 yards across the 35 to the 37-yard line. Bernstein in as a tight end. Murray back to throw across the middle, and he's got the first down across the middle. And that is Bernstein, the man we just mentioned. A&M in its first game. Alabama in its second. Here's Murray back again, looking again. And that ball is caught. What a play by Shea Walker, his second outstanding clutch catch of this game. And Oklahoma State and North Texas State on field goals are tied at 3-all. Third down and 8 to go. Murray running for his life. Has time now. Throws and overthrows his man. That was Jeff Nelson at the 18-yard line. It's fourth down. Bell, the man in motion. And that's Braggs with the ball. And he's not going to get the first down. Just gets to the 15-yard line, and that is all.
When you're struggling on offense, Jim, like Texas A&M, they're doing, and especially in this first half, it's very difficult for the team to collect themselves and come back at it.
Here's Murray. Murray gets the ball away, and it is caught across the way by Nelson. Run out of bounds by Freddie Robinson, but first down. Inside the 35-yard line. 4:45 to go in the half. 7-0 Alabama. Woodside, the man in motion. Whoops.
Murray fumbled the ball. Did Bama get it?
I don't know. I could only say whoops because I didn't see who did get it.
When they all start pointing that they have, that means they didn't get it.
We'll see. They've already had one turnover, Alabama, or rather Texas A&M. Matt Wilson may have gotten it back. He's their center. They fumbled the ball. Overcame that as far as getting the ball back. Now it's second and 9. And here's Murray back looking for Nelson. And overthrows him, and oh, does Wilkinson want that back? Vernon Wilkinson had that ball right in his hands. Two wide receivers to the left, and Woodside flanked left. Murray looking left, gets the ball. Boy, does he drill that ball. To Shea Walker, first down, inside the 10-yard line. Wayne Davis, inside linebacker, put him down. First and goal to go, Texas A&M. All right, third down, goal to go. Ford is one of the wide receivers. He's just in there. Murray is back, running, setting it up, and he's got Woodside, and Woodside is inside the 5-yard line, and Turner takes him out of bounds. Keith Woodside, and now decision time. And it's going to be a 19-yard field goal attempt by Eric Franklin, who had not missed before and has this ankle now as they refuse the delay of game. Make it just about a 20-yard.
He got it.
He got it. And the Aggies are on the board with 2:46 to go in the first half on 3rd and 6.
Throw to that big tight end, Chandler.
Shula gets Bell, and Bell gets the first down all the way out to midfield.
There you go.
On first down, Shula throws it to Turner coming out of the backfield, and Turner gets away from Holland and is put down by Domingo Bryant. First down near the 35-yard line, 1:29 left.
But that keeps the clock moving. There's 47 seconds to count.
And they got 3 timeouts, and they can't save them until the next half.
Yeah, they're no good then. Here comes the blitz.
And there goes Shula. Down and back at the 40-yard line. Sadler the first to reach him. Number 99.
Take a timeout.
And on comes Van Tippen. And this would be a ton.
57 yards.
A ton. He has hit 2 out of 3 between 40 and 49. He hit a 1 of 41 yards and 1 of 48 yards. And 53 yards is his best. And as Paul said, this will be a 57-yard attempt. 57 yards out.
He's got it.
He's got some leg, and he's got it. That's his best.
The 53-yard field goal by Van Tippen. That was the school record, and now the 57-yard field goal record here.
Throw it right down the middle. Now they're going to run.
Well, that's Vic carrying the ball, and Roger gets out to the 14-yard line. Nobody is stopping the clock. 9 seconds running out. Alabama scored first with a touchdown and scored last with a field goal. And the first half is now over, and Alabama leads by the score of 10-3. Flags got the touchdown, and Van Tiffin and Franklin got the field goals. 10-3 Alabama. We've got a big second half coming up and a big halftime coming up. Bader kicks off. And that is Humphrey at the 8-yard line. A lot of speed, this young man. A lot of speed. And taken out of bounds. Across the way, but he's crossed into Aggie territory. Richardson and Bell, the wide receivers. And Shula to throw on first down if he can get it away, and he cannot get it away. As quickly, Todd Howard, the linebacker, junior out of Bryan, Texas, makes the tackle for a loss. And you're looking from behind Chris Moore. Mike Bobo, the fullback, hasn't been in the ballgame as a running back tonight, played a lot against Georgia. They've gone pretty much all the way with Turner. Good kick. Good kick. Let this go. He'll let this go. I hope. No, he's going to catch it inside the 10. That ball would have gone in the end zone. Cannot believe it. Stump comes out. He started the game. And down in this territory, we're running is the situation. He starts the second half. Tony with the football. And that's a good run by Tony of 7 yards off of the 12-yard line. Again, that is Tony, and I think he may have it. Maybe across the 15-yard line, and that's all he needs.
He got it by half the ball.
Stump, passing from his own territory, and has his tight end, Rich Seiler. And Seiler's got the first down. Wayne Davis to make the stop. Stump. Up, hit just as he went to throw the ball. By John Hand, the big number 78 coming in. They're picked about fourth by the Southwestern Conference Writers to finish fourth, I should say. But on SMU, Arkansas, maybe in there with Houston in third. Second down, and here goes Turner trying to go on that side. And Turner does a good job of it and gets across the 35-yard line and very close to the first down. Two tight ends as Howard Cross joins Thornton Chandler. No throwing at all tonight, the tight end.
Oh,
what?
Oh,
I don't know if he made it. Don't know if he made it. There's Shuler carrying the ball on the option play. What's the football? And let's see who got it. They say the Aggies got it. Asbury, number 16. When Asbury recovered the fumble to give the Aggies the ball at midfield, and Kevin Murray is coming as the quarterback, and he's back to throw on first down. Has the time, has the man, Nelson, first down, 35-yard line, Alabama. Now we have Bernstein, a tight end, who has split wide to the left, the wide receivers on the right side. They shovel the ball ahead to Roger Vick, and Vick is immediately wrestled down by number 55, Derek Thomas, a reserve linebacker. Fourth down and four to go. Murray always got the first down. Right there to catch it is Keith Woodside. Second down and 20. Murray has his man Nelson. What a catch. And he may have the first down.
He does.
On second down 20, Nelson falls out of bounds. They give the ball instead to Vic. And Vic gets good yardage down near the 7-yard line. 10-3 Alabama. Here come the Aggies. 3:45 to go, third quarter. This is third down and about two. The ball on the 5. They get the ball to Tony trying to get outside, and Tony may have the first down. First and goal to go inside the 3. Remember, this drive started at the 50-yard line when Shula fumbled the ball. Tony carries the ball. Touchdown. So the Shula fumble, recovered by Asbury, resulted in a
including a big penalty for holding. And now they're a point away from Alabama. In all of last year, Anthony Tony was trapped behind the line of scrimmage only one time the whole year. And Turner carries the ball and still has the ball and got a first down. Sneaked along the left side of the line of scrimmage and came out, and Johnny Hollenfield back to put him down. First down, Alabama. Third down and inches to go. They did the ball to the second man through, and Brax has got the first down. Across the 40 to about the 42-yard line. First down, Alabama. Third, a long three. Shuler's going to throw it out. Oh, look at this. Wide open is Bell. Nice move there. Asbury with him. First down. Ball on the 39-yard line of Texas A&M. First down, Alabama. Humphrey. And he's got speed hot on it for showing, but he won't catch him. Others will. Another first down, Alabama. Inside the 25-yard line. Kelm put him down. Landrum, another linebacker, comes in as Shuler goes back on third down. Aims the ball to Richardson right off his kneecaps. It's fourth down. That would not have been a first down where he was. All right, here is Van Tiffin. And it'll be from 40 yards out to put Alabama in front by three. Van Tiffin has plenty of leg, but is it straight? Yes. Alabama goes back on top on the 40-yard field goal by Van Tiffin.
They're not even waiting. That was 87, Roberts, not Bennett.
There's Murray in trouble. They'll not get out of it. Back at the 5-yard line. Third down and 14 to go. Whoops, they lost the ball on the handoff to Tony. It's fourth down. They'll have to kick from their own end zone. Third down and 6, Alabama. Shula puts the ball out there and has Thornton Chandler. First time they've thrown to a tight end on either side tonight. And that's the first down, Alabama, at the 30-yard line of Texas A&M. No flag. Shuler in trouble. Down he goes. Fourth down. Great job by the Aggies. Keeps them in the ball game. The ball at the 35-yard line. Well, since Van Tiffin has set a school record tonight with a 57-yard field goal, they will now try a 51-yard field goal. He is kicking into the wind. It is not a strong wind. But now we see it slowly, and that is going to do it from 51 yards out. Big play, third and short.
Go left.
But he dropped the ball, and who got it is more important.
Alabama's putting her hands up again. That means that Texas A&M has it.
It could be Matt Wilson again, the center, who gets up with the ball. All right, before they come to the line of scrimmage, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25 seconds have gone off the clock. And it's still running. Over 30 seconds from the time the ball was down. Here's Shula putting ball out to Bell. Oh, is he a weapon for the tie? First down, Alabama near midfield. A good move. Nobody but Shula. The naked reverse on the bootleg. He's got the first down. Both Turner and Braggs went right. Shula put the ball on his hip and came left. And it's first down, Alabama.
Jim, what a super call by Perkins and his staff.
We've not seen Greg Richardson for some time on punt returns or in there trying to catch the ball. Here's Turner carrying the ball again. He was busted loose. And there he goes. Touchdown, Turner. 32 yards. And that does it. Jay Walker goes wide to the left, and Nelson comes to the right. And there's a throw across the middle of Bernstein, the tight end. He's got a first down across the 40-yard line. And Cheryl's Aggies have not given up. Van Tiffin also set the record for Alabama with 57-yarder earlier. Here's Murray. Down he goes again. And there's that man, Larry Roberts, out of Dothan, Alabama. Fourth down. They've got to go.
He said, beginning of the week, didn't he? This is one of the toughest teams we'll face all year.
That's right. Murray throws. The ball is completed out there. Woodside got it, but that's not going to be enough. Ray Perkins' team has won second in a row. They had their worst season ever last year, but they're off to a great start this year.
You see them when they're on it, shaking hands with the coach on the side, Jim. There's all these sighs of relief. Whoa. We got out of this. Good game, though. Good game.
Now they'll count it down. All over. Alabama wins it second. The Aggies have lost their opener. Teammates Perkins beat Cheryl 23-10. Alabama, the final score.